When playing, some strange movements of the toes are noticeable. We are going to fix these issues in several steps. Let's select the right foot bone and the toe bone. Go to F-curves, then rotation. Let's do the same with the left toe. Now we got rid of the strange movements, but introduced penetration into the floor. This is easy to fix. Let's bake animation to control rig. The floor penetration is gone. If not, then go to the character settings. In modifiers, find floor contacts and make sure the feet floor contact is checked. Let's hide the bones. Let's look from the side view. Make a new animation layer. Enable trajectory. Go to the frame where the foot is about to rise. Enable selection mode and set 0 key. Move to the frame where the foot touches the ground and set another 0 key. Let's rise the foot up here and set the key. And a couple more keys. Closer to the end, the character makes a step back. Let's also set 0 keys at the beginning and at the end of the step. And in the middle of the step, lift the foot and set the key. In order to firmly place the feet without slipping, we will use auxiliary factors. Until the frame where the character puts his foot on the floor, the auxiliary factor will have no effect. And in the next frame, it will have full effect. But IK foot control will be opposite. It will have full effect until it hits the ground, and no effect on the next frame. Let's make a new auxiliary factor. Again, the auxiliary factor will have full effect in the next frame after the foot touches the floor, and no effect on the frame before. The IK foot control has influence on this frame, and no effect on next frame. Here on this frame, foot is about to lift. We need full foot control. Until previous frame, foot was on the floor. We don't want foot control there. But for the auxiliary effector, the opposite is true. We want total control when the foot is planted and no control when the foot is about to go up. Here at the beginning, let's make another auxiliary effector and set it to full control. We maintain complete control as long as the foot is on the floor. And when the foot is about to come off the floor, let it go. Again, the foot control has complete dominance as the foot is about to leave the floor. And no control one frame before when the foot is planted. Let's set 0 key at frame 30, where A pose ends and animation begins. On frame 29, make the auxiliary effector have no power. Let's check how it works for the right foot. Not bad. Now let's focus our attention on the left foot. Here we will reuse an auxiliary effector instead of making a new one for each step. First, set keys for each landing and lifting of the foot. Then make an auxiliary effector when the foot touches the ground. Set the keys for the IK values as we did with the right foot. Let's change the color of the left auxiliary effector to distinguish it. Here we set the translation key for the auxiliary effector. In another step, we select the auxiliary effector, then drag and drop from empty space to the foot control. Select Align, Translation, Rotation and set the key. We have successfully repositioned the auxiliary effector. The rest is the same. Sorry, here I forgot to raise the left foot. Let's check our work. Remember, the first few frames transition from A post to animation, we need to simulate closes. Good, from frame number 30, no sliding at all.